Okay, well, I'm filming with this piece of shit camera that seems to be screwing up, but now it doesn't want to screw up, so I guess I'll keep trying to use it. But we got this Godin A5. Boy, did it get dropped. So I'm gonna flip it over. There's a big battery cavity thing in the back. Maybe I can get in from the inside as opposed to having to try and squirt glue from the outside. Let's look. It's actually a cool looking five string thing. Ooh, neato. With some sort of synth thelicizer in there. Well, once, I don't know, let me plug it in before, while the strings are all loose. Let's just look at the damage before I get ahead of myself here. I just sort of noticed a crack there too. I don't know if Buddy knew that. But anyway, I'm going to try and sneak in from back here and see what's in there. Well, no such luck. Close. Close, but no cigar. So, I got to take the neck off so I can get this up in the air where I can. Oh, look. Little bits are coming off since I've been handling it. Okay, let's figure out what we can do here. Well, I decided not to make more work for myself. You know, taking the neck off and all that doesn't matter. So, once again, using my fancy, who the hell are these guys again? Multi-grip Wilton soft rubber clampy things that clamp onto everything. Holy crap, look at that. Look, your computer plugs right into it. Okay, let's glue this thing. I'm using SM50. SM stands for Sicomet, which is a brand name of cyanoacrylate. And the 50 is the thinness of it. We could buy this in large quantities for gluing all kinds of stuff together at work. So they were kind enough to let me steal a small bottle and take it home. Okay, it's getting sucked up into this guy. And then we're going to spread this open a little bit and push that down in there. And then I'm going to clamp it and run for the hills. So I got this little tiny screwdriver in there and twisted sideways to hold it open while I use the tiny end of this thing here to get the glue in there. Let's do her up. I hate playing with this shit. Ah, you bitch. That was no fun. So I'll have to give it a little polish. I had to get adhesive a bit on the surface because of the flaked finish. Otherwise, that would have flaked off and looked even worse. But I'll be able to polish that back and should all be good. I'll leave it for a while. Time for lunch. Well, you gotta love the clamping. Come on. So yeah, I'll hit the end of the guitar on the polishing wheel. There's still a little bit of a remnant of the breakage, but yeah, and if you drop it, it'll probably pop apart again there next time too. Just don't drop your guitar. And with fairly good success, she's glued back together. I guess I could plug these in. I gotta plug that. I don't know about that P bass. I don't want to get any more on me. Well, this sucker's fairly hilarious. Of course, it's got two buttons that don't seem to do anything. And I'm working with... Well, that piece of shit's going into the shop. Fuck, I hope I get my movies off it fast enough. Another hunk of junker. Yeah, so if this one croaks, I'm gooched. Wow, she sure goes low. Does it zoom back anymore? There, you get to look at my freaking chicken legs. The string action is like a mile off the fretboard, but I guess you could remedy that because it's a bolt-on neck. I never looked to see if the neck was like straight or not. Oh, the neck's warped like a frickin' banana. Should I tell the guy? Should I straighten it out for him? I guess I better. Okay, back to work. Ah, shit, I wasn't even recording any of that fun stuff. I adjusted the truss rod. It was flapping in there loose like a goose. Holy moly. I never, like, made the transition to five string. I was already famous after it was invented. I could see an advantage to that, like if you were playing in a weird key where there's no like C or, you know, something where there's not a lot of open strings for a bass player. Let's try that gucked up jazz bear, P bass thing jazzed up.